And welcome back to Fairfield, Connecticut at the William H. Pitt Center, where the Sacred Heart Pioneers just defeated St. Francis for a huge NEC victory. The Sacred Heart's 11th of the season. Chris Caiozzo is standing courtside with winning coach Rob Machen. Chris, take it away.
Here with head coach Rob Machen. Coach, congrats on the win.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
Coming off a loss last week, what did you tell the girls coming into tonight's game?
We actually were trying to work on certain things. St. Central was a very good team, and they kind of exposed a weakness in our defense. Kind of worked on that all week and tried to apply it tonight.
All three sets, 2 points, 2 points, and 2 points. What do you guys practice for those games, for those sets?
At the end of these sets, we do a lot of our drills are drills of completion in practice. You have to finish them to get through them. But I got to give the athletes credit on this one. They're fighters. You know, we shouldn't have been in those positions, to be honest, but we found ourselves in them. Whenever we do, we always fight and find a way out of it.
Tonight was a game of runs between the Red Flash and you guys. And you guys found yourself down early, and you called an early timeout. What was said during that timeout?
I didn't think that we were playing with the urgency necessary. We were up two sets to none at that point, and we started to cruise a little bit. And St. Francis is a very good team. They're going to keep hitting you all night long, and if you give them any life like that, they're going to run with it, and they did.
Going into tomorrow's game for Robert Morris, what's the mindset for tomorrow's game?
Another good team. Robert Morris is a very strong team. They're more dominant in the middle, so it's a little bit different defensively for us. But if we attack well, serve well, and we keep our setter jumping at the net, that's what our real goal is. If she's jumping at the net, we're very hard to do it.
And we're looking forward to that. Coach, again, congrats on the win.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
And we'll bring in player of the game, Julia Murawinski. Julia, congrats on the win.
Thank you so much.
It was I was just talking to Coach about this, a back and forth game of runs. What was in your guys' heads all game?
You know, St. Francis is a really good team, and we knew that coming into this match, so we just had to play like we know how to play and how we've been practicing the whole week preparing for this game, and we really executed that tonight.
Now, you look at the scoreboard, 3-0, but all sets were close. How do you guys prepare for this?
It's a mental preparation, you know? You're playing a good team, you have to really be on your best game, so we knew coming in that it's going to be a hard-fought game no matter which way it went.
You guys have a lot of rookies on the court between Sarah, Emma, and Alex on the outside. How proud are you for them?
Oh, I love them to death. They're my little freshies. Like, they are amazing athletes, overall amazing competitors, so it's really great to have them out there.
Looking forward to Robert Morris. What are you looking forward to the most?
Playing how we played today, it's the first time that something has really clicked and the energy kept going, so it's going to be really exciting tomorrow.
Julia, congrats on the win. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
No problem. And we'll be back after the break with a quick post-game recap.
So my memories as a little girl are in a volleyball gym.
My neighbor, Betsy, she played volleyball. I wanted to play volleyball.
We single filed into the gym, and the first step that I took, I just had these crazy chills. It was a really emotional moment for me.
What do you want volleyball to do for you? Where do you want this path to take you? I want to be on the USA Olympic team. I want to play in the Olympics one day.
Surreal is the word that I have to use because it's something that I never have experienced before.